Southern Swing continues at Benedictine, catching up with Danny Britt. So how was your offseason?
John, it was good, obviously, after winning a lot of fun stuff. And so, it's been really good, and the returning guys are working really hard, as always. And so we're very excited to get it going.
All right, time to talk the R word, and I guess two R words, reclassification and region. Right. When it comes to everybody having a plan, some folks had to have a plan more than once. Right. Now that the plans have been all planned, look at reclassification for me now that it's over and where you are for the next 2 years.
Yeah, obviously we stayed in 4A. We were supposed to be in 3A, but we had chosen to play up. So we've been in 4A and we're staying there. Region gets a little tougher, obviously. You add in Southeast Bullitt, adding Burke, adding Wayne. So, but that's good. That's good. You get more games, and I'm excited about the region.
When it comes to filling in schedules, I know traditionally it's been tough for you because, I mean, you've had to go to – basically Neptune sometimes to find non-region games.
Right.
How difficult was it this go-round?
Well, we had some already locked in, even though it was a new schedule with some Florida schools. And so we've got Christopher Columbus out of Miami again, which we travel to in 2 weeks. And the boys are very excited about that. and then we have bowls. And so we've made a decision that we're going to continue to do that year in and year out and just get that kind of experience for our kids and that kind of competition. It can only make you better. And I can assure you playing the 8A state runner-up in Florida will make you better.
Because, you know, that first season, which is your non-region schedule, right. You want it to line you up for your second season and your third season. And you talk about travel and going all over the place. Those kind of intangibles that folks don't necessarily trigger in their head right. will help you come playoff time.
Without a doubt. I mean, one, you get tested, and you're pushing yourself to be the best you can be as soon as possible. Two, you see where you're weak at and how to fix it. And then three, you learn how to travel. You learn how to make those trips so that if you are fortunate enough to make it to a state championship and have to go up and spend a night in those type of hotels and stuff, you're used to it, you've experienced it.
When you look back over what you've been able to accomplish here, does your first day here on campus seem like yesterday, or does it feel like it was that long ago?
You know, gosh, it's both in between. It feels like forever ago. A friend of mine, Baker Woodward at mm-hmm. Savannah Christian, sent me a picture of me my first year. I ran to Tybee from here. Mark Stroud and I did at Calvary, and just for a fundraiser. I look so young. And now I'm gray and fat, and I'm like, what happened? So that seems like forever ago, but sometimes it seems like a minute. It's been a great run, and I've really enjoyed it, and I look forward to the next 10 years.
That is the story here at Benedictine as we head toward 2022.